nights play chess. And when I'm out, I'm looking for that vintage fling. But all complexions that I adore, so hard to find, these seem impossible to score. So I dream on to someday find that vintage love.
I've gotten my top of my table cleaned off. I had some straw pieces, and I'll show them to you. I had some straw haystacks, and these things shed like crazy. So what I did is I sprayed it with my husband's hairspray, because this is stronger than mine. So I sprayed it really good, and I'm thinking, or I'm hoping, that it doesn't shed. I can see a little bit of shedding. So maybe it won't shed as bad. So I'm going to use this in my farm scene on the bottom. I've already got my tree that I showed y'all. If y'all follow me on Instagram, that's at Vintage Southern Belle 16. I had made this on, or showed y'all how I made it. So I've got it sitting there, and I'm not even going to do this. Let's go ahead and light it so y'all can see that too. How cute is that, guys? So I'm going to decorate this top. I can't wipe this top down because it is that rustic wood. This is from an old barn that my great-grandfather had. So I had to vacuum it down. So we're gonna do this part. We're gonna do the nesting box, and then we'll do underneath all together. So I wanna put my straw in the back of it. So I'm just gonna kind of place them here and there, and it's not shedding near as bad as it was. So I want to do two, I think, right here, kind of stacked, and then maybe y'all can see that better, maybe two over here. It's still shedding some, but not near what it was. I bought these little pumpkins, and I thought they would be pretty, kind of sitting around here and there. Put my little red truck right in front of the barn. That's normally where I put it, but I found this at Hobby Lobby. It's a cute little wheelbarrow, and I thought I could put a pumpkin in that as well. So I bought this from Hobby Lobby. It's some hops, and then I had the wheat as well. So I thought I'd put that coming out of the back of the truck. And some squash, and a pumpkin or two, and then a pumpkin in that. That's a little big. Maybe I can swap this one out. Yeah, that's better. And of course, I have my animals. I have a cow, my little donkeys. These little pumpkins came with little pine cones too. I want y'all to see those. Look how little, look how little they are. They're so sweet. This little area over here is for my chicken coop. Now, once again, I bought this from Marnie's Uniques. I bought the barn and the little chicken coop. I want y'all to see that. That is so precious. So I'm going to stick the chicken coop kind of back over here with my little chicken. So since we've got the tabletop done, the tablescape, let's move up into the nesting box. Now you can see I've already got some galvanized pieces in the back. I've got a chicken feeder, and then I have a chicken and another. What it is we took galvanized buckets and cut them in half. I was going to use them as lamp shades for lights mounted on the wall. Good gracious, I can't speak today. But I just put them in there because it added some extra color, and I thought it was real pretty. So I'm kind of weird like that. So let's decorate this area. My thought was, and I'll show you. Y'all probably remember I purchased this from Hobby Lobby, and it's a long piece of garland. So what I did is I cut it up into pieces, and I thought I could put it. And now I have stuff down inside because it is pretty deep down in there. So I have, and in fact, this is what I got when I graduated high school. It's just a little Lane cedar, like jewelry box. So I stuck that right there. It's the perfect height. So I'm going to put my greenery piece kind of in the front just to give it some texture. And then put my pumpkin inside. I think that is really sweet. I love the greenery with it. I love the height of it. So on this one, I'm going to do a little different. I have these really cute potted plants, and I'll tag them down below. They're from Amazon. The pot is so stinking cute. And then I think this is called rosemary, but I have three. It came in a thing of three. So I think there's like eucalyptus, this, and another kind of more of a rounded top leaf. So I'm gonna add that in there with a pumpkin. So once again, I'm gonna layer my greenery. And I've still got my chicken feeder back there, which I think is really cute. Let me see if I can get this to lay a little different. All right, and then, of course, and my pumpkin. That looks cute. Now for the next one, once again, I have another. This is actually a cigar box. My boss smokes cigars, and he gives me cigar boxes a lot, and my brother does. So I put that in there, perfect height. Once again, let's try. Let's do a different kind of pumpkin. I'm going to put another chicken feeder in here. It's a little different. Then I've got my greenery. And then I have found these at Hobby Lobby. These are just pumpkins on a stem. You know, they quit their sale. I think everything was 40% off. So all that's over now. But anyway, there's my greenery. And then I want to add this kind of to this side because I have that one on this side. So I'm kind of mirroring it in a different fashion. Does that make sense? So I don't want all of my stuff on one side. I want to move it back and forth to carry the eye differently across the piece. And then I'm just going to add my pumpkin. And the leaves look really pretty with the greenery. So look at that. So pretty. Look how your eye carries across the piece. So you know how I said these two pumpkins are very similar. These are slightly different. They're a mirrored image of each other, and so are these. Very, very cute. Let me kind of get up and see if you can see that chicken. You see the chicken in the back? How stinking cute. And then the top of our piece. And so here's the landscape of the tabletop. Now let's do the underneath. Okay, so we're underneath the cabinet, and Bear's gonna stand here and watch me because if I'm on the floor, he's gonna be right here with me. Hello, say hello. Okay, go play. All right, so this is an old toolbox of my dad's. And so I put it down here and I like the look of it, but if you look at it, it kind of matches the metal on the back. So I think what I want to do is I found this buffalo plaid rug and we're going to try something. And this booger's heavy. So my thought was just to bring some more color in is to lay this across here, kind of like a runner, and maybe even fold this up some. I don't know. All right, so I've got my rug down, and then I vacuumed the rug and put the piece back in there because I didn't want y'all to see me struggle trying to get that thing back in there because it's heavy. So I have some little pieces down in here, and I thought that it would kind of help build up inside. And then I have this straw that I'm going to use for something else. But if it will fit down in here, it'll actually give me some height. All right, so I've got my bales of hay down in there. Let me turn this over. Yeah. And what I want to do is, I've got some greenery. I'm going to use it. But I'm going to use it in the back. So this is that banyan greenery. I'm just going to put that in the back. And I got this off of Amazon. I can post that down in the link, a link down as well. Now these I got at Hobby Lobby, but I have seen them on Amazon. So I can link those for you guys as well. I'm just going to kind of fill in with those. Ooh, it's already looking pretty. And then I bent these down earlier, so I'm just gonna kind of stick those in the back. Then I have these three pumpkins. Oh wait, I got this eucalyptus I could stick in there to kind of fill that hole. And I have three pumpkins. Now look, I have two that are identical and then one that's different. So what I'm gonna do is put the identical ones on either end. And then the orange one, add more to this. I could put corn husks in there. I could do all kinds of things, but I think I'm going to leave this pretty simple. So y'all see that area over there where the tobacco basket is? I purchased this yesterday at Home Goods, and it was so cute, and I got it for $7.99. But since it goes with my truck theme, I was kind of hoping I could stick it right there. That doesn't look bad at all. It brings some color in, but oh, that's better. I like that better. I like it leaning. All right, now I have this bucket side, and I don't really know what I want to do over here. So I love my bucket over there, and I kind of want to leave it, but I think I want to add some fall colors to it. So I think I'm going to take the doily off, put my grapevine wreath in, and do some other things. So let me get
right, so here's the bucket. So I already had the wreath back in there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my buffalo plaid pillow cover. I'm just going to kind of put it that way just to bring the buffalo plaid from down here over to here. Then I had this basket that I had bought some time ago, and I'm going to put it in there, kind of caddied. And I know I probably miss a lot of things in my kitchen, but I'm going to put a bowl down in there. I'm pretty used to it. I know where I can find it. And then I have this half sphere, which still has the tag on it, but the half sphere with the pumpkin berries. That is sweet. My display on top, and then oh my gosh, the underneath, how pretty. So I have a door area that I have an antique door, and my husband just hung some pegs right there beside it. So let's do that together. So this is a full-size door beside our front door. I'm sorry about the light coming in, but this is the only way I can adjust my camera. So I have this peg rack on the side. What it was is when my husband hung this particular door, he wanted it on studs because it is a heavy door, it's antique. And then we did put the shelf on the front. I got some area to hang things, and then we had this opening area here, and I could not figure out what to put there. So I found this accordion style peg hanger, and it fit perfectly. So I'm excited about decorating that. I have just gotten that here. So I'm going to do kind of a fall scape here. So let's see. I had that piece from Kirkland's that I had bought, and I thought, oh yes, I love that there. How cute is that on that door? I love the chippiness of this door. It gives me that vintage look with the new green color. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. All right, so I have my scale that I normally keep on my shelf. I think I want it right here. I love my little scale. Let me show y'all a little trick. So I have this old book, and I love this book, but I love it even more because I took the center out. It was already ripping out, so I took the center out, and I put these packets that you get from Kirkland's inside it to give it some smell. So when you walk in the front door, you smell my sachets. Perfect idea. So I put my book there. I think I want to do my chicken right there. Oh, he's so cute. And then, let me think. I have this little pumpkin piece, some blue. What else do I need? Since I do live in the state of Alabama and it's got some blue on it, I almost think it needs more fall. And I have this greenery here. Let's see how that looks. It's got some gold stems in it. So let's lay that kind of short piece this way, long piece this way, and then we'll just drape this little piece of greenery, fall greenery that I have behind the chicken. It's not bad at all. Then I'll put my little Sweet Home Alabama and my blue pumpkin. That's cute. All right, now I want to do this right here. And I had seen that these fit These are my blue and white cups that I love. So I'm gonna kind of piece those in here and there. That's really sweet. I have these beads that I thought about using. They're gray with the brown tassel, but I don't want them hanging long. So I may. That's kind of cute. I don't know if y'all can see that. Now I need something right here. I have this green piece of greenery that I had bought from Hobby Lobby, and I may just leave it like that. Doesn't look bad at all. So maybe I can get it all in for y'all. Look how cute this is. So this is right beside our front door. And I love the little peg. And then I'm gonna kind of sweep around. That I just hung, that is for Bear's leash and stuff. So I thought it worked out perfect there. He hears me saying his name. And then the nesting box, my barn scene, and the bottom. Tell him good night, Bear. Say night night.